What's up, guys? This is Ryan from Tower Reviews, and today we've got a speed test for you. Six iPods. We've got the first generation, second generation, third generation, fourth generation, fifth generation, and sixth generation. As you can see here, we actually have the third generation indicated by the 32 gigabyte on the back of it. And here we go. Let's get right into the speed test. So we've got all six iPods lined up next to each other. We're gonna hit the power button at the same time, and we're off to the races. Alright, so it looks like the sixth generation turned on first, followed by the second generation. Then the fourth generation. Now we've got the fifth generation on. And the first generation. So looks like the third generation is coming in last, oddly enough. Now these speed disparities don't really make much sense, as you would think that the newer technology would come out first every time. But there's other variables you have to consider, including the software that each iPod is running. Alright, so now we have all the iPods up and running. So we've got some interesting results there. Of course, the sixth generation did come on first, which is to be expected. And here you can see just a profile shot of each of the iPods, getting a little look into the differences in design. Of course, we have the 30-pin on the older iPods, and the lightning on the new ones. Alright, so now we're going to take a closer look at each iPod, starting with the first generation, of course. Now, this iPod was released back in 07. This was my first ever iOS product. It had a 412 megahertz processor along with 128 megabytes of RAM. It had no speaker, and it didn't even have the App Store when I first got it. The latest software it runs is iOS 3. And as you can see, the design looks a lot like the first generation iPhone, actually. It has the stainless steel backing, plastic on the bottom, and the plastic window for Wi-Fi connectivity. Now, in everyday usage, this iPod's actually not that bad if you're just going to be using it as a media device for music and maybe the occasional video. And also, it's also internet connected, of course, so you can go on Safari, and every now and again, if you want to, you can do a quick web search. I wouldn't recommend it for much more than that, but back in the day I used to play Call of Duty Zombies on it, and it was actually a pretty nice device. I used it a lot. As you guys can probably see, it's taken a beating. It has scratches all over it. The back is absolutely scratched up, but yeah, I mean, it holds up pretty well. The battery's still intact, and yeah, so that's about it for the first generation. Let's move on to the second gen. So as you can see here with the second gen, this was a pretty radical redesign. You have the rounded back, again with stainless steel. This is the 8GB version. Still have the plastic Wi-Fi window and 30-pin dock connector on the bottom. Now the big new feature in this iPod was the addition of speakers and volume rocker on the left-hand side. This iPod came out in 08. It has a 533 megahertz processor, 128 megabytes of RAM. And the latest version of iOS that this iPod can run is iOS 4. Now, again, in everyday usage, this iPod is, as you would expect, if the first generation was good enough, then the second generation is probably good as well. So yeah, you can use this as a media device, really whatever you want to do with it, as long as the the version of the software doesn't limit your use. But yeah, so now we're going to move on to the third gen 32 gigabyte. So here we have the third generation. It's pretty hard to distinguish between this and the second gen. A lot of people actually confuse this because Apple actually kept the second generation. They kept the second generation for sale at the same time the third gen came out. But the only difference was the third generation had the 32 gigabyte hard drive on it. So that is actually what we have here. Again, it has speakers, it has the plastic Wi-Fi window, 30-pin dock connector, power button on the top. It had a 600 megahertz processor when it was released in 2009, as well as 256 megabytes of RAM. So we actually see a double here in the RAM from the last generation. and this iPod can run up to iOS 5. Again, it's fairly fast for everyday usage. As you can see here, it lags a little bit, but that's to be expected with, you know, 7-year-old technology. But you can do the odd web search here and there, and overall it's a nice device. Now we're going to take a look at the fourth generation, which we have right in front of you. Now, this iPod Touch came out in 2010, and this was the actual second iPod Touch that I own personally. I used the first gen right up until the fourth generation came out. This iPod has the A4 processor in it, so it was very similar spec to the iPhone 4. Now, the big addition to this iPod was the addition of front and rear facing cameras, as you can see. Now, they were very low spec. I don't know the exact megapixel, but I want to say under 1 megapixel. Now, it did have an 800 megahertz processor, 256 megabytes of RAM, so it was pretty close to the third generation in terms of RAM, but the processor was 200 megahertz bump, so this thing performed pretty well. And it also had the addition of the Retina display, which was very important, because obviously it's much better to look at, to watch videos and things like that, which is what you're going to be doing with it. Alright, so now we're going to move on to the fifth generation, which was essentially the iPhone 5 without the cellular technology. Now, we did see a major upgrade to the camera, 5 megapixel. Along with that came a flash. We still have the plastic Wi-Fi window, of course, and the other big addition to this iPod, which was kind of stupid, was the loop button. As you can see on the back, that silver button that we just saw, you could pop it out and attach a lanyard to it. We have the front facing camera there, home button, and we also saw the addition of a 5-inch screen, so that was very nice. This iPod is still very much usable. This can run up to iOS 9. It has the A5, which is an 800 megahertz dual core processor, so you get about double the processing power of the fourth generation. It has double the RAM of the fourth generation with 512 megapixels, and it can record 720p video. So this iPod was a very big upgrade, probably one of the biggest in the whole iPod Touch lineup. And this came out in 2012, so there was a pretty big gap between the fifth generation and the sixth generation, which you can see here. This just came out in 2015, as you can see here, and this iPod, while it keeps the same design as the fifth generation, has major upgraded internals and camera, and also the disappearance of the loop button on the back. Now, looking at the camera, you can see that we have 8 megapixels. Very nice. We still have that 4.0 inch screen, so they didn't go with the larger size, I guess, to put more of a disparity between the iPods and the iPhones. They didn't want people walking around with the same size screen. So overall, this iPod is a pretty big jump. We have the A8 and M8 motion coprocessor in this device, so you can track physical activity with this, which is really nice. If you want to take it on a run, it will be able to track your steps. It has a 1.1 gigahertz dual core processor, so it's packing a lot of power in there, as well as 1 gigabyte of RAM, so double the iPod Touch fifth generation. And it does have that 8 megapixel camera, which allows you to record in 1080p as well as take slow motion video, so you can do a lot of stuff with this iPod. It's a very nice media device if you're going to be using it for maybe controlling your Apple TV, or you just want it for music and to be able to track your fitness. So yeah, guys, that's about it for this video. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like below and subscribe to the channel for future videos. Thanks for